What did you make? Show me what you made.
Is that your airplane? Let me see.
He's going to the fire.
Oh, is it a fire airplane?
Yep.
That is so cool, and you painted it. And what is this right here that Daddy made you?
That's a tent.
It's a tent?
Wee, wee, he's getting higher. Wee, wee, wee.
Is that what you made?
Wee, wee.
Hey guys, so it is Saturday, October 6th, and we just got back from Home Depot. The first Saturday of every month, they have like a kids workshop, and we like to go to that. And Miles loves making whatever they have and painting it and stuff. So we went to that today, and then we don't have anything planned for the rest of the afternoon, so I kept thinking, what can I do? Because I basically have done everything. Yesterday, I spent all day cleaning every single square inch of the house. I vacuumed all three floors, I dusted, I cleaned all four bathrooms, I mopped the floors, swept, I did some laundry, I cleaned the showers, I deep cleaned the kitchen, like basically everything, and I vacuumed, did I say vacuum? Vacuumed all three floors. So basically like there's nothing to do. And the day before that, I did a bunch of freezer meals, which I did a video of that. I'll link that down below if you want to see what I did. So I pretty much, there's nothing to do except for just keep the house clean and wait around for babies. So Simeon's doing school today. Miles is playing downstairs right now in his little tent thing. And I thought I would do some postpartum prep stuff and just kind of share with you like postpartum must-haves. With Miles, I had a second degree tear with stitches, so I'm hoping I don't tear this time again. But I'm still doing some of the same postpartum stuff as last time because I really enjoy these products. So let me show you what I've got and how I'm going to prepare them. So first of all, you're going to need lots of pads for postpartum, and I just like the U by Kotex ones, which I have not bought pads in probably like a really long time because I actually use a menstrual cup, but I don't want to use it for my first couple, well, for postpartum and my first couple cycles, depending on when it comes back. So I just bought some pads, and I really like using a menstrual cup, but I did buy pads a year ago when I had my surgery, because I didn't want to use my cup for my first period after surgery for my endometriosis. So I just bought some of these, and then also I'm going to make some padsicles. I just got some lavender witch hazel, and this is the alcohol-free formula. Because, you know, alcohol down there does not sound very good. So I'm going to make some padsicles. I think I made these with Miles. I can't remember. But I do know that the hospital gave me, like, ice packs and stuff to put down there, which was, like, really soothing. So I'm going to make just probably maybe three or four of these in the freezer. And then after I have the baby, I can make some more if I need some more. But I just want to have them in the fridge or the freezer just in case. And then the other thing is that I absolutely love with Miles is called a sitz bath soak. So the birth center gave me the sitz bath. I need to clean it up. I mean, it's been cleaned since I used it 4 years ago, but it's been up in the closet collecting dust. So I just want to have it ready and down here so that way Simeon doesn't have to worry about that after we get home. But anyways, so I love this Mother Love sitz bath. I think I got this online at Target. You can also get it on Amazon. I'll link it down below if you're interested. But this stuff is amazing. So it's a little bit different than what I had with Miles. Let me open it for you. With Miles, it was more of a like a tea form. Well, not like tea, but it was like tea leaves and stuff like that. And you had to steep it for like 10 minutes in boiling water and then let it cool before you poured it in here. And so when I went to go order some this time, it's actually already in a liquid form. It's the same exact ingredients, except for in liquid form, which I think I like that better because then you can just add warm water and put it in there and it's ready right away. And you don't have to wait for it to steep and then cool and stuff like that. So basically this just like sits in your toilet and then you fill it with your sitz bath. And I know there's other things you can add to it. Like you can make your own or whatever, but I really liked this one and I didn't want to have to worry about making my own. And then you just fill it with warm water and you sit in it, and it's really helping with like the swelling and the healing, and especially if you have stitches and stuff. But you know, of course, ask your doctor, you know, if it's okay to take a bath and stuff. I've heard of people using this like in the straight bathtub, but I think you'd have to use more. And some people, the reviews are saying it like stained their bathtub or something. I don't know. But this is just more convenient because it's more localized. And then the other thing that's great for postpartum is a peri bottle. This is the one I've had with Miles. And I'm probably just going to throw this one away or keep it as backup. But the birth center, they'll give me one. So a peri bottle is absolute must have for postpartum. So those are like the healing down there products. And then the other stuff that I have this like belly binder, and the hospital gave this to me. Well, they didn't give it to me. I'm sure I paid for it somehow. But it just kind of helps hold things in. I remember when, after I had Miles, I was like walking around like doubled over, like holding my belly, and they're like, you need a support band to like hold everything, because everything like just feels like jelly and squishy, and like it just, it feels so weird. So I use this a little bit with Miles, so I'm gonna just get it down and get it ready and have it down here, because it was up in the closet, so I just want it easily accessible in case I want to use it again. And then my other favorite postpartum item is called this Milk Saver. So I'm gonna wash this up, but basically it's like a silicone thing, and you actually put it like in your nursing bra or whatever, and obviously your nipple goes in there, and it catches any leaks or drips while you're nursing. So what I would do with Miles, like I think I only use this like maybe for the first week or two or something when I was like leaking a ton, but I would nurse him on one side and then I would put this on the other, and it would catch, because I would have a letdown on both sides, and I would leak like at least 2 ounces from the other side. And if you're using like disposable nursing pads or even cloth ones, or you don't have anything, I mean, you're gonna be sopping wet. So I absolutely love this, and it's kind of small and trim, so it's, you know, nothing big and bulky, and it's just really easy to use. So, and then it's got this little stand here, so when you're finished nursing, you can just stand it up until you're ready to go, like dump it, and you can just dump it into a bottle or a bag or whatever. So this thing is a lifesaver. So I'm going to wash that up. I'm going to wash this up, and I'm going to make some padsicles. Here is, I'm just gonna put some in this little spray bottle here, so that way, you know, I can spray it down there. It's really great for hemorrhoids and just, you know, for soothing. This bottle is not the one that goes with this. I'm gonna put this one here. Nope, not that one. Alright, so I'll just pour it in here. And then I'll just keep this in the bathroom. There we go, that one fits. I'll keep it in the bathroom and I can just spray it and then refill it as needed. I don't want to fill it all the way up because I don't want to use up all this in case I want to make some popsicles. And then the other thing I wanted to show you is this smaller spray bottle here. And I filled this with apple cider vinegar after I had Miles, because he had a little bit of brush on his tongue. And so my midwife told me to spray my nipples after each feeding with apple cider vinegar so that way I wouldn't get it. And I didn't end up getting thrush, and then it ended up clearing up for him. I didn't have to use any medication or anything. And so I'm gonna just have this down here ready. It's all cleaned and ready to go. Just in case baby girl starts to get a little bit of thrush, I can use this and fill it up. I'm not gonna fill it up now because, you know, if she doesn't get thrushed, then I don't wanna put apple cider vinegar in here, but that's just a little tip that my midwife gave me. Phone with my insurance company,
it's my turn to talk.
It's your turn to talk? Okay, well, you gotta get down because the window's too bright. Come over here, sit in front of your tent. Sit in front of your tent, and you can talk. Sit. There you go. Okay, go ahead.
So, I'm playing with my garbage truck, and I'll clean it up.
You'll clean it up? Yeah, so, you made a big mess.
And Ted, he made it because I don't know
how to make it. Daddy made it for you?
Yep, and pretend I'm a real Ted's and pretend Ted's.
Okay. Yeah. So I just got off the phone with my insurance company because I can get a free breast pump through my insurance. And I have to wait until after the baby's born or else the insurance won't cover it, which is kind of inconvenient because then, well, Simeon can go pick it up for me. But still, it's like I won't have it if I needed it right away. Which I didn't really need it with Miles. We didn't get a free one with him, so I just bought like a $100 one at Target. I think it was the Medela Swing. Awful quality, like I could hardly pump anything with it. So I have to go to like a home, just a minute. I have to go to a home medical supply store and show my insurance card. And I think she said, I need to call and double check, but this is what the lady at the insurance company said. That I have two choices, a Medela, I don't know which one, or the Amita. And I was really hoping for the Spectra 2 because I've heard really good things about that one. So now I need to do some research and figure out which breast pump I would like to get, which one's better, and actually call the places and see what they would have for our insurance. So yeah. Simeon just got back from the garden a little while ago, and look at this ginormous zucchini. Like, this is a normal size one that you'd buy at the store. So I'm gonna make some minestrone soup tonight. He also ran to the store and got some beans because I didn't have any of those. So I'm gonna make a zucchini chocolate cake, which is really good. You can't even tell there's zucchini in it. I'll link the recipe down below. And then also I'm gonna make some fresh zucchini bread, and then this will be for the soup tonight. And then he also picked some green beans. We even have more than that, but we're all kind of green beaned out. So that's gonna be for the soup. And he also picked a bunch of peppers and tomatoes. So here is the ginormous zucchini all shredded up. So I've got my 2 cups measured for my chocolate cake, and I don't have any baking soda, so I need to figure out what to substitute there. And then this is like 5 cups of zucchini shredded, and I'm going to make a triple batch of my zucchini bread. And we used the last of the flour. We barely had enough, so yeah. I didn't really plan this too well. So here are my 3 loaves of zucchini bread and the chocolate cake. And then we've got our soup here, and I've got some of the bruschetta bread from Trader Joe's in the oven.